Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about why you should be using Fastlane tools for deployment. Okay, so yesterday I uploaded like 23 different apps to Google Play. I still have a bunch more to do. One of the things I talked about in recent weeks is the change to GDPR meant we had to add this consent form to a lot of our apps, which for if you have like two or three apps, that's annoying. If you have 10, it's really annoying. If you have like 50 or 100, then it's super annoying. Some apps probably won't even come back to life. Basically, what we did was we removed them all from the App Store, all the free versions on the 25th of May, and it's been on my to-do list to put them back. So yesterday, doing all these bulk additions to Google Play, and I'm not even bothering with the App Store because they got the 4.3 error, and I'm not even going to go down that route again. Screw Apple. I'm not doing that anymore. All right? So, I mean, they do pay me every month, so I mean, through app revenue for a few apps, but I'm not going to put all the apps on there again because it's too much of a hassle. But Google Play, it's still a case of doing that. And every time I do something in bulk like this, I think, thank God for Fastlane tools, right? As I get out there, I've done a video on this before, just saying how much easier it makes things, right, in terms of going through the process. But usually I use Fastlane for updating metadata. So when you have like all the different screenshots and different language conversions and everything like that, then you do. But have a look at my screen here. Here's Fastlane tools. For those of you who aren't using it, especially if you have like an agency where you do a lot of stuff for clients, or you have a lot of apps on your own, is something that if you're not using it, you probably should be. So Fastlane, most of the tools on Fastlane, and by the way, Fastlane is a set of tools developed by Felix Krauss, who put those out there. He's like really active in the developer community. You know, if you read his Twitter, he's always got really interesting things on there and everything like that, and his blog, right? So a lot of the tools are geared towards iOS. So continuous integration, so you can have everything go, so it builds, it deploys, it updates the screenshots, does everything all in one command, so it takes seconds instead of, you know, half an hour or an hour, so it saves a lot of time. So, and a lot of times I focus on it for iOS development. In fact, look at my screen over here. This is kind of for doing the metadata. A couple years ago, I went through and localized in all these different languages. So that was a lot to do, but with Fastlane, you can just type in a few command lines and it will download all the metadata into one folder. So I'd have the description, the short description, the title, the video, and then the different screenshot sizes. So it does all that. I could just go update that, do a Fastlane tools again, and it will upload it and everything's done without having to go through the laborious process of going into Google Play and everything like that. So let's look at Google Play. Google Play used to be a lot easier to deploy an app too. And this is one of the things I thought about. So now this is Learn Thai Bubble Bath Game, right? Which is released a version yesterday, a new version. So there's a whole part of setting things up with the metadata and the description and the screenshots, everything like that. That's one thing. But even just doing like a simple update, like I just needed to upload a new APK. So like normally what I would do is I go down to, over here on the left, I would go to release management, I would go to app releases. We've got all the beta and the different release versions, but usually I just go to the production track. If it was doing something for a client, or if it was something that I had like a beta user's, if it was like a usually popular app, I might go the alpha and beta route, but normally I just go into production, go into manage, go into create new release, upload the release, upload the new release notes, and then go to review, say 100% deployment, and then do that. So that there's lots of different clicks in that process. So you'd say if you have like yesterday, 23 apps, each one of those steps might take me about 5 minutes, and then it would just be kind of this whole thing. But if you take it into Fastlane tools, let's go over here to my terminal. Fastlane tools, all I have to do is type in Fastlane supply, the JSON key, which is the key with all my Google Play data, the location of the APK, and then the package name. And then you just do that. It uploads everything, it creates the release, it releases it to the App Store, and does everything like that. It's just super simple, very easy, and if you're doing something where you do it in bulk, it really does help. So anyway, I just wanted to do a quick video on that. For those of you who aren't using Fastlane tools yet, you might want to think about it. It really does save you a huge amount of time. So anyway, that's it for today. Hope that's been useful. By the way, for those of you who aren't using it, a lot of you guys are using it for continuous integration, so you have the whole process. For me, I'm using Corona SDK, so it's like this manual process in the middle. So I have a bunch of code that will get the code ready, so it moves everything around, puts everything in the right place, and then I go into the Corona GUI, and then I go through, I have to go through the menu items, build, assign the key, all that stuff, and build it. So that does slow things down because it doesn't really have a very good command line interface, or there's at least one that's not very well documented that I haven't been able to figure out. But then from that, I can just take the APK, upload it to the apps, to Google Play, and then everything is ready, and it just speeds things up considerably. So anyway, that's it for today. Let me know if you guys are using Fastlane or whether or not it's something you would like to learn more about, because there's really good resources out there. I mean, that what I just showed you now, Fastlane Supply for Google Play, Fastlane Init, right, to download the metadata. I think it's Init for... It might be it's Fastlane Supply for both about downloading the metadata and everything like that. So it saved me so much time in the past. I mean, we're talking about dozens of hours, just that it saved me over the past year. So that it's a fantastic tool. Anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow. As long as I'm still